concentration and delta G. For the following reaction, the concentrations of A, B, and C at equilibrium are 0.522 molar, 0.466 molar, and 0.355 molar, respectively. The temperature stays constant at 25.0 degrees Celsius. A. Calculate the value of standard delta G. B. If the concentrations of B and C were each 0.200 molar, what concentration of A would be necessary to have a delta G of negative 6.00 kilojoules for this reaction? Since the given concentrations are already at equilibrium, we don't need to use an ice table. We simply need to find the equilibrium constant. The concentrations of the products are multiplied together and then divided by those of the reactants. Their coefficients become exponents. Next, we insert our equilibrium constant into our formula that relates the equilibrium constant to the standard free enthalpy value. We get an answer in kilojoules with three significant digits. For part B, we are going to use the answer we just got. It's better to use the non-rounded version. Now, we need to determine the concentration of A necessary so that the non-standard value of free enthalpy is negative 6.00 kilojoules. We will use the following equation. We will put the reaction quotient equation inside of this one. Let's take a minute to clarify that K and Q take the same formula, but they're not actually the same. K is the equilibrium constant and describes a reaction at a certain temperature. Its value never changes unless the temperature changes. Q is the reaction quotient, and it describes the state of the reaction at any moment. Comparing K and Q, we can determine if the reaction will move towards the products or reactants when heading towards an equilibrium. When K and Q are equal, the reaction is at equilibrium. For this equation, we need our standard and non-standard delta G's to be in joules. So, we put the negative 6 kilojoules in as negative 6,000 joules. We put in the standard delta G calculated in part A. Then we also put in the universal constant, R, the temperature, and the given concentrations. We have to solve for A using algebra. First, we simplify the concentrations. We subtract the value of standard delta G from each side. We divide by R and the temperature. By putting both sides of the equation as base E, we can eliminate the log function. Lots of decimal places are kept in these calculations in order to not lose any precision. We isolate A by bringing it to the left side of the equation. We take the cubic root. Everything can now be put into your calculator. We finish with a concentration of 0.602 moles per liter. Again, we round our answer to three significant digits.